The Philippines Army is using everything from heavy earth-moving equipment to boats to rescue thousands of people and their animals from the rising floodwaters. The government has declared a state of emergency in the south of the country. President Gloria Arroyo has ordered major cleanup and rescue operations. When high tide arrived, residents in many villages watched the floodwaters rise up to their necks. Some were desperate enough to risk their lives in the rising tide. This community in Mindanao didn't stand a chance when a river burst its banks, swallowing up everything in its path. Typhoon Feng Shen arrived with a vengeance, bringing winds of 160 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 195 kilometers. In a matter of seconds, the strong winds tore down power lines and felled trees. City streets were quickly transformed into rivers. Typhoons have become a part of life in the Philippines. About 20 hit the country every year, triggering floods and mass evacuations. Environmental groups say illegal logging is making their impact worse. Challenging rescue operations are underway in several southern provinces where towns have been inundated by floodwaters. In the capital, Manila, army personnel are cutting down trees felled by the storm and dismantling damaged billboards to ensure no one is injured by falling debris. Typhoon Feng Shen is expected to move away from the Philippines on Sunday and head north towards Taiwan. Hannah Belcher, Al Jazeera.